A lot of rain in the forecast for the West Coast this weekend. Here now with more is Dr. Marty Ralph. He's a researcher at Scripps Institution of Oceanography. Doctor, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Sounds like you guys are having fun.
We always try to have fun around here, especially when Chrissy Russo is here and she was singing your praises all week. So we thought, you know what? Let's talk to this guy and see what's going on. A lot of rain expected. And we always hear the term, she loves the term atmospheric rivers. But then I thought, what does that mean to like the common folks out there like me? It's like, what does that mean exactly?
Yeah, it's basically a river in the sky, but it's a river of water vapor instead of liquid like on the land. And it just, they can transport amazing amounts of water vapor. One atmospheric river, if you slice across it, is transporting horizontally about as much water vapor as 25 Mississippi rivers.
Oh my goodness.
And when that hits the coast or the mountains, it can create a lot of heavy rain and snow.
So
and that's an average day.
So how much rain really could this dump on us and on the West Coast, given the size of this atmospheric river we're seeing now?
Well, we've developed a scaling for ARs to help distinguish the weaker ones from the stronger ones, mm-hmm. the ones that are probably going to be mostly beneficial because we need water usually, and those that are more hazardous. And the scale, you know, runs from 1 to 5. The ones and twos can be, you know, a few inches. The threes and fours can be, you know, quite a bit more in the wettest spots. And the fives can be up over 10 inches, you know, in a couple days in the wet spots. And we've got an AR5 knocking on the door
wow.
here right now for Northern and Central California, which is quite rare for October.
Yeah, I was going to say that that must be rare, and it is. Would this be enough, given the size of it and it's a five? Is it enough to take us out of our drought? Can one system, can one AR actually take us out of a drought?
One system isn't enough to do that, but a set of them could do it quite well. This one storm or sequence of ARs, including the big strong one in it, I would expect to produce about 10 to 15% of the equivalent of
wow.
the average annual precipitation. So one storm, 10 to 15% of the year's precip in the spots where it hits hard. We won't get that much down here, but up in Northern California,
sure.
that's looking pretty likely.
You know what Chrissy was saying, that we always hear the term too much too soon. Like, we want the rain, we want this in California and the West Coast, but sometimes it's too much too soon. Explain what that really means for us and for the West Coast.
Well, I'm not sure about the too much too soon bit. Usually we want to get off to a good start.
Yeah.
But I think the point is that getting a good wet start in October doesn't guarantee it's going to be a wet year overall.
Hmm.
In fact, it's not uncommon that we get a very wet period in California and then it just dries up for a month or more afterwards. That's not unusual.
Sure.
But getting off to a good start is better than not. And given the fire problems, the terrible fire problems in the state, you know, the last couple of years, this rain is a blessing for, you know, making sure that that's going to end, at least in Northern California. And hopefully if we get enough down here, you know, it'll help suppress it down here as well.
Yeah, it's critical. Is there a way, a new way perhaps, to capture more rainwater before it flows out into the ocean? And in other words, could that affect our lives and how?
Yeah, great question. And we're working very closely with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, the California Department of Water Resources, local water agencies across the region and the Northwest to explore the use of atmospheric river forecasts, which have some accuracy to them that could be useful,
yeah.
to use those forecasts to help operate reservoirs more flexibly. We've actually had some success with it on the ground, so to speak, in Northern California with Sonoma Water Agency. We're experimenting on it with the Santa Ana River and Prado Dam in Southern California, the Yuba and Feather Rivers in Northern California, which are really key to the state's water supply, including Southern California's. And then also now we're starting a project up in the Seattle area. So the hope is, the plan is that we hope to find it viable to use forecasts of ARs to help make reservoir operations more flexible.
I want to end this with a bit of a loaded question. Do you think these are more intensified due to climate change, or to what do you attribute? You said these are rare, the one that we're getting now, but how does climate change affect what's going on
yeah.
right now, what you're studying?
Well, climate change is predicted to increase the size and occasionally the strength of ARs, you know, on the West Coast. And this, in addition to that, it's likely to increase the time between ARs. In other words, it could be dry for longer. So we may get more of our precipitation and fewer, bigger storms, which can create some challenges, of course, for water management.
Fascinating stuff. Dr. Marty Ralph, we really do appreciate you taking the time this morning to help explain it all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.